Northcott. I'm one of the co-founders and executive chairman of Eudaemon Technologies. And we're an early stage medtech company focused on sexual reproductive health. Our mission is human flourishing through material innovations. And our first product that we're bringing to the market very soon is the hydrogel condom. And that product is serving a significant unmet need and a $60 billion global burden of disease.
Our main focus is replacing latex with tough hydrogel materials. Now, this is to make a better feeling next generation condom. So the primary issues with condoms at the moment are that people don't like the feel, they have problems with the odour, they have problems with the colour, they don't like the taste, and this really makes people choose not to use them. This is a particular problem because we have over 1 million STIs being diagnosed every day, and we have up to 120 million unplanned pregnancies every year. This results in close to a $60 billion health burden across the globe. And so we're really targeting on and trying to assist and empower people to give them a device that they want to use to overcome those issues. So to do that, we plan to replace latex with these tough hydrogels. So tough hydrogels are soft, squishy plastics that soak up water, so they feel more like skin. They have no odour, no taste, they don't cause allergies. And because of the water phase within the material, they can even be loaded with small molecule drugs, so for things like flavours or even anti-STI compounds.
The history of this company and the innovation came from a call from the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. And many years ago, they had one of their grand global challenges to look at this issue of unplanned pregnancies and STIs and innovation in sexual reproductive health. And our team, Professor Rob Gorkin, one of the co-founders, and Simon Cook, my second co-founder, along with Rob, created this opportunity to respond to that grant and to build an opportunity through this hydrogel technology.
We were a team of academics all working on this challenge. So as you'd imagine with something like a condom, it's a very broad multidisciplinary challenge. So we worked with a team of people like myself who was involved in microbiology, material scientists, designers, neuroscientists, and a really broad team of people to really drive and allow us to understand how we could solve a challenge like developing a next generation condom. Tied to that is the commercial aspect of medical devices, so making sure that you can transmit or translate these devices into the market, and that's where we founded Eudaemon Technologies to support that purpose. So Eudaemon was formed, you know, after the research program had existed for a few years, and the company was founded in 2018, and we really took that multidisciplinary angle of being targeted and having a diverse skill set to solve this challenge. So the team at Eudaemon now is really built around that core kind of group of people that have the core expertise in developing the condom. And where we need expertise into the future aspects around commercialization or clinical and reg strategies, we go out and find those partners. So where we are now is RDE Group's facility in Leichhardt, and they've been a fantastic partner of ours and helped us develop the technology in terms of the manufacturing and the quality management system around those products. So globally, we have a team of researchers and staff now that help us develop the technology, and we drive as a company to make sure we make the right decisions to ultimately get it to market.
We're looking to help users or consumers of those medical devices have a better experience. And we've been supported through a range of different schemes to really de-risk the technology development, including the New South Wales Medical Device Fund, two occasions of fantastic funding from our friends at New South Wales Ministry of Health and Office of Health and Medical Research. We've also been very fortunate to receive funding from the federal government's entrepreneurs program, the Accelerating Commercialisation program, and that was an important bridging piece of funding too. More recently, Eudaemon Technologies has been supported via funding from the MRFF project, the CTCM Clinical Translation and Commercialisation Program, which is supported by MTP Connect and the MTAA. To give an update, Eudaemon Technologies has had a massive 6 months. We've completed our pilot clinical trial, recruited up to 35 couples, and just this week we had database lock on our data, which is a massive milestone. What this means is that we've been able to demonstrate that we can produce safe, effective, high-quality condoms and use them in clinical studies. That has meant that we've got really strong signal, both in terms of safety, but also in terms of the effectiveness and the preference towards our product. So we're really excited about what the future holds for the company. Our next steps towards commercializing and getting to market are a few things. One, making sure that we're capitalized and funded in order to get through a process of scaling our manufacturing to be able to go from the thousands of units we can make today to ultimately hundreds of thousands, millions, and ultimately billions. And there's a big process around that in terms of being able to create the relevant subsystems, the verification and validation on that, and the process controls aligned with the ISO standards. Then being able to produce condoms for our pivotal clinical study, and ultimately then commercializing the technology and getting it out to market once we have regulatory approval. So we're really excited about the next stages and as we continue on in our journey.